So today we will be discussing about one more important concept in the financial management. We will be talking about the financial decision. As a financial manager, every manager has to take three important financial decisions. The three important financial decisions related with the investment, related with financing, and related with dividend. So these are the three major important decisions which every finance manager has to take: financing decision, investing decision, and dividend decision. Okay, financing decision. This is related with the raising of the fund. As we know that there are number of sources through which we can raise the fund. Okay. We have got borrowed capital, that is debt capital. We also have got the option of owner's equity, that means we can raise the money by issuing the share of the company. We can borrow the loans from the financial institution, we can issue the debenture. But out of these sources, which source is most suitable for us, in what condition? So there are certain factors which we have to think before we take this decision, that how we have to raise the fund and from which source we have to raise the fund. So the factors we will be discussing, few factors like cost. Cost is one of the important factor. When we are raising the fund, let's say from the borrowed fund or let's say from the owner's equity, so what is the cost involved in raising the fund from these type of sources? So that we have to think. Okay, cost is one of the important criteria. कि कितनी लागत, कितनी कीमत लगेगी इन चीजों से या इन सोर्सेस से पैसा लेने में, हमें पैसा कितना खर्च करना पड़ेगा. वन इज फ्लोटेशन कॉस्ट. फ्लोटेशन कॉस्ट इज दैट कॉस्ट विच वी हैव टू स्पेंड, लाइक वेन वी आर इशूइंग द शेयर फॉर रेजिंग द फंड. By issuing the shares, we have to give the prospectus. So for that prospectus, we have to print it. So we have to spend some money. Then we have to appoint some agents or commission agents who will be doing this work for us. So these are the costs which will be incurred on raising the fund. So flotation cost, if the flotation cost of raising the fund is more, so there we have to make the use of the debt capital. Okay, flotation cost ज्यादा है, अगर ये खर्चे ज्यादा हो रहे हैं, commission ज्यादा जा रहा है, prospectus पैसा ज्यादा लग रहा है, तो हमको debt capital देखना चाहिए. अगर उसमें हमारा पैसा कम जाता है as an interest, तो we can go for debt capital. If flotation cost is high, so then we should use debt capital. Okay. Risk. Now what is the risk involved? There is a lot of risk. Risk कैसे होती है? The shareholder may change the balance of the company. If we are raising the funds by issuing the share equity, so there will be number of shareholders. और जितने ज्यादा shareholders बढ़ेंगे, so they will become the active participants in the management, and then they may change the balance of the company. Because there are number of persons who want to take the participation in the management, so we have to hear from them also. And company may not like this. Debenture or the borrowed fund, again this also may do the same thing. They may also pressurize the company to pay them the regular interest. Okay, so this may be one of the cause for taking the not taking the funds from the debenture holders, so they may also pressurize the company to give them the returns on time. Okay, they want the safety of their money. So these are some of the reasons. So we have to think wisely that which source should be utilized by us. Then comes cash flow position. Cash flow position of the business. The cash inflow should be more and the cash outflow should be less. And if we want to get more cash inflow, so then we have to think of the debt capital. बाहर से पैसा लेने की सोचिए तो cash inflow position अच्छी रहेगी. volume of operating cost. There are some fixed operating costs like salary, wages, maintenance expenses, electricity bill, telephone bill. These are some of the fixed costs. So what is the volume of this fixed cost? If these fixed costs are already high, so then we should not think of raising the funds from the borrowed funding, because it will create another pressure on the company, it will create another liability for paying the regular installment and the interest. So in that case, we have to go for the safe side and we should raise the funds by issuing the equity. Okay. So there also we have to take all these decisions judiciously. Then company control. If the company do not want to dilute their control, company अपना control dilute नहीं करना चाहती है, so then they should not go for raising the fund by issuing the equity. क्योंकि अगर वो शेयर इशू करेगी, इक्विटीज इशू करेगी, तो नंबर ऑफ शेयर होल्डर्स विल इंक्रीज एंड व्हेन द नंबर ऑफ शेयर होल्डर्स विल इंक्रीज द कंपनी विल लूज इट्स कंट्रोल, द कंट्रोल ऑफ द कंपनी विल बी डाइल्यूटेड एंड डिवेंचर एंड अदर बोरोड फंडिंग द कंट्रोल विल नॉट बी डाइल्यूटेड एंड एवरीथिंग विल बी इन द हैंड्स ऑफ द कंपनी ओनली. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द बेसिक फैक्टर्स विच वी हैव टू थिंक बिफोर raising the fund from the market as a financing decision. Now we come to investing decision. Okay, in case of investing, this is the decision related with the investment what we are making. When we are talking about the investment, there are two types of investment, short term investment and long term investment. When we are talking about short term and long term investment, so how much money should be invested in the current assets, or how much money should be invested in the fixed asset, then we have to decide. So this is all related on the investment decision. So investment decision, before taking that decision, we have to think of some factors. Rate of return. Rate of return on investment. What will be the return? The money which we will be investing in any particular project for a long term basis. So what returns we will be getting from that? हमको उससे कितना return मिलेगा? So on the basis of that thing, we have to decide that whether we should go for the equities or whether we should go for the debt capital. If the returns are more, okay, and the money which we will be buying from the market, on that we have to pay lesser amount of interest than what we are getting in the form of return. So there we can think of raising the fund from debt capital. मान लीजिए कि आप बाजार से पैसा ले रहे हैं, उस पैसे पे आपको ब्याज जो है वो 6% लग रहा है, पर जिस पैसे को आप बाजार से ला करके इन्वेस्ट करेंगे, उस इन्वेस्टमेंट में आप जब कमाएंगे तो वो रिटर्न जो है आपको 8% के हिसाब से मिल रहा है. So in that case you can take that 6% money from the market एज अ टैक्स कैपिटल. क्यों? क्योंकि उसमें 6% में लेकर के आप उस पैसे को लगाओगे तो उसमें रिटर्न जो है आपको 8% 10% मिल रहा है, तो वो उससे ज्यादा है. सो दैट इज जुडिशियस, वो सही है. कैश फ्लो ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट. नाउ व्हाट विल बी द कैश फ्लो ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट, हाउ मच मनी इनफ्लो विल टेक प्लेस. ओके, सो द मोर इनफ्लो will take place on any investment, जितना ज्यादा investment आप करोगे और जितना ज्यादा inflow of money आएगा, so on the basis of that thing we have to take this decision that which source should be used by us. Okay, so inflow and outflow of money is also one of the criteria. Inflow ज्यादा आ रहा है better, outflow ज्यादा नहीं होना चाहिए. तो inflow अच्छा आ रहा है तो inflow of cash outflow से अच्छा है. So in this case what will happen, you will get more money. Okay, so that is the condition where the cash flow on investment, where you have to take the decision that whether debt capital should be used or the owner's equity should be used. Then lastly, the use of capital budgeting technique. We are making the use of the capital budgeting technique in the proper way or not. The techniques are related with the investment which we are making, investment in the current assets or investment in the fixed assets. When we are taking this decision, so we are thinking wisely before doing the investment, debt, how much returns we are getting, what will be the payback time period, what will be the discounted payback time period, पैसा कितना मिल रहा है उसको इन्वेस्ट करेंगे, रिटर्न कब आना शुरू होगा, उसका हमको पैसा देने की बारी कब आएगी. सो ऑल दिस थिंग्स वी हैव टू डिसाइड और थिंक बिफोर वी गेट द फंड फ्रॉम एनी पर्टिकुलर सोर्स एंड डू द इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ दैट फंड. तो इन्वेस्टमेंट करने से पहले आपको ये सारी चीजें सोचनी पड़ेगी. सो दिस इज ऑल रिलेटेड विद द फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग द इन्वेस्टमेंट. ओके, नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिविडेंड डिसीजन. ओके, द डिसीजन रिलेटेड विद द डिविजन ऑफ द प्रॉफिट. डिविडेंड इट इज दैट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रॉफिट विच इज गिवन टू द शेयर होल्डर आफ्टर all the payments related with the taxes. Lastly, the dividend will be declared. So in this case also the financial manager has to keep the things in mind that how much amount should be declared in the form of dividend. So there are number of factors which should be considered. Internal and external, two major factors are there. When we are talking about the internal factor, liquidity position of the company. That means the cash and the bank balance which the company possesses and the assets which the company is having, whether the assets can be converted easily into cash or not. If this thing can take place, then the company can think of declaring the higher dividend. Okay? Then comes shareholders' preference. Some of the shareholders are there who want the regular income, stable income. But some of the shareholders, they want the increase in the prices of their share. कुछ shareholders चाहते हैं हमारे को higher और stable income regularly होनी चाहिए. कुछ shareholders चाहते हैं कि income भले थोड़ी कम हो, dividend भले थोड़ा कम हो, तो जो भी पैसा आगे invest किया जाए company के द्वारा in the productive activity, so that the value or the goodwill of the company will be more and the prices of the shares of the company will rise. So both these aspects are to be considered by the financial manager before declaring the dividend. Then comes extent of earning stability. Earning stability is the, if the company is earning regular profit and the profit margin is very high, then they can think of deciding the higher rate of dividend in comparison to those companies who are not having the regular or the stable earning. Because this stable earning helps the company to declare the dividend even in the time of the crisis also. क्योंकि अगर company की earning अच्छी है, एक stable earning है company की, बहुत अच्छा पैसा कमाती है, तो वो अच्छा dividend declare करे, higher rate पे करे. और कई बार ऐसी कंपनियां क्या करती है कि किसी साल अगर loss भी होता है तो वो अपनी अर्निंग में से कुछ पार्ट जो है उस साल भी डिविडेंड के रूप में डिक्लेयर कर देती है. सो दिस बेनिफिट इज नॉट अवेलेबल टू दोज कंपनी हूज अर्निंग इज नॉट स्टेबल. फाइनेंशियल नीड्स ऑफ द कंपनी इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द फैक्टर. दैट हाउ मच मनी इज नीडेड बाय द कंपनी फॉर द री इन्वेस्टमेंट पर्पस. कंपनी अगर पैसा री इन्वेस्ट करना चाहती है इन एनी प्रोडक्टिव एक्टिविटी, then they will declare the lower dividend. But if the company does not have this type of thing, कि अगर company आगे पैसा invest नहीं करना चाहती है, the shareholder demand that they should be getting more and more dividend, so company has to take a judicious decision that how they have to satisfy both the things. Shareholder को भी satisfy करना है और company को अपनी retained earning भी बनानी है कि then some part of the profit should be retained. So that it can be used in future for any opportunities which are being coming in the ways of company, through which the company can earn more profit. So financial need is also one of the things which is the factor which you have to consider before declaring the dividend. Now another external factor. अब अपन चलते हैं external factors की तरफ. Legal constraint. Due to some legal constraint, you have to declare the dividend. कुछ चीजें आपको लीगली ध्यान रखनी है और लीगल कॉन्स्टेंट में आपको ये भी ध्यान रखना है कि फ्रॉम वेयर यू हैव टू डिक्लेयर दैट डिविडेंड. दैट इज कैपिटल कैनॉट बी यूज for declaring the dividend. Dividend can only be paid out of the present and past profit, and any insolvent company will not pay dividend. Dividend declare करते समय आप ये ध्यान रखेंगे कि आप अपनी पूंजी को इस्तेमाल नहीं करेंगे dividend declare करने के लिए, कि किसी भी insolvent company को dividend declare नहीं करना है, और dividend declare करने के लिए आप सिर्फ अपना present या past जो profit का amount है सिर्फ वही use कर. तो ये लीगल पॉइंट से बात हो रही है. देन कम इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन, प्रिवेलिंग इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन. व्हाट इज द इकोनॉमिक सिनेरियो ऑफ द कंट्री? इफ द इकोनॉमिक सिनेरियो इज नॉट गुड एंड द कंपनी इज नॉट गेटिंग द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ द वेरियस पॉलिसीज विच आर बीइंग फ्रेम्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट एंड द कंपनी इज नॉट अर्निंग द प्रॉफिट ड्यू टू सम ऑफ द इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस विच आर टेकिंग प्लेस, so in that case the declaration of dividend will be at the lower end, and if the economic condition of the country is sound and company is getting all types of economic benefits, the policies are going properly and the companies are earning good profit from that, so in that case the company can declare the higher rate of dividend. Okay, at present you can see this thing, that what is the scenario in the present time. Due to the lockdown, many of the companies are not working for a particular time period since last so many days. So definitely we can think this thing, that by the end of the year when the turnover of the company will be measured and the quantity will be measured and the quantum of profit will be measured, definitely the company might not be in the position to declare a good dividend, because all this is due to the scenario which is taking place in the country at the present moment. Then comes access to capital market. What is the access to capital market? That means the ease with which the company can borrow the funds from the market. So if the company can easily borrow the funds from the market, then they can declare the higher rates of dividend. Higher rate of dividend does not mean that by borrowing the money from the market you have to declare the dividend. But when you are borrowing the money from the market, then you can declare the dividend from your profits at the higher end, and you can make the use of that money for your business purpose and for your productive activity, and by this you will be able to get the more opportunities of getting the finance from the many more number of financial institutions. इससे आपको एक मौका मिलेगा कि आप ज्यादा से ज्यादा financial institutions से पैसा ले सकेंगे, because your earnings are stable, you are giving the higher rate of dividend, so investment will come definitely towards you, and for that you may have to borrow the fund from the market also. So if it is easily available, then you can think of higher rate of dividend. Investment opportunities. If there are any investment opportunities in the business, the nature of your business is, let's say, technological, so technology keeps on changing. टेक्नोलॉजी बदलती रहती है, एंड फॉर दैट वी हैव टू इन्वेस्ट द मनी ऑन द रेगुलर बेसिस. सो इफ देर आर द इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन योर बिजनेस, देन यू कैन थिंक ऑफ डिक्लेयरिंग द लोअर रेट ऑफ डिविडेंड, एंड बाय रिटेनिंग दैट मनी विच यू हैव केप्ट विद यू, यू कैन इन्वेस्ट दैट मनी वेन द अपॉर्चुनिटीज कम टू यू, एंड यू कैन अर्न मोर एंड मोर प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम दैट. बट इफ देर आर नो इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन द बिजनेस, then you can think of declaring the higher rate of dividend. So all these things were related with the various internal and the external factors, okay, which we have to consider before declaring the dividend to the shareholders. Now overall we have discussed the three important decisions which are to be taken by the financial manager, that is financing decision, investing decision and dividend decision. And then what are the factors which we have to consider before taking all these decisions? If we are taking into consideration all the factors, okay, then only we will be able to make the use of this decision wisely, and then only the company will be able to get the benefit of all these things, okay, and the company will be able to grow more and more, okay. So all these things are clear to you, three important decisions, financing, investing and dividend. Thank you.